So good evening students, today I'm going to talk about the important topic related to your syllabus, that is environmental concern, which is related to the third unit, and we are going to cover many important topics from that unit. So without any delay, we are going to talk about environmental concerns. Before proceeding, students, I would like to invite a discussion from my end that whenever we talk about environmental concern, we usually talk about the international problems related to environment or international problems which we had caused to, we meant for mankind had caused to the environment, needs to be adhered or talk. Therefore, we may understand this is an important topic both in the environmental sciences and the assessment of tourism impacts either way. Nowadays, this particular world is witnessing a lot of problems, especially into the area of global warming. Global warming or the rise of temperature conditions are being talked recently a lot. In our previous session also, we have talked about many international conventions where the global warming has been discussed. So before proceeding further, we need to understand what is global warming. Students, global warming is the rise in the average temperature of Earth's atmosphere and ocean since late 19th century, and its projected continuation. So, rise of temperature in throughout the planet, and its record after a substantial end of 19th century, or since early 20th century, Earth's mean surface temperature has increased about 0.8 degrees Celsius or 1.4 degrees Fahrenheit. About 2-3 increase occurring since 1980s. Global warming is believed to be caused by increasing concentration of greenhouse gases produced by human activities such as the burning of fossil fuels and deforestation. Students, whenever we talk about the global warming, it is to be understand that the global warming, the term called global warming, and the term called greenhouse gases have got the interconnectivity. Whenever we used to talk, there is an outcome that greenhouse gases are, or emission of greenhouse gases are responsible for the global warming. Now, what are these greenhouse gases are? Greenhouse gases, by the way, by their chemical nature, they have got the potential of retaining the temperature. It is like the blanket effect, or you have studied in your school days about the nature of carbon dioxide, where, or carbon monoxide, where the temperature conditions are being seized by those molecules, and further then they increase into the environment so that the gradual temperature conditions in the world scenarios have been drastically changed, and it has been witnessed since 1980s on record. Last 20 years we have witnessed a gradual change throughout the globe about the temperature conditions prevailing on planet Earth. The effect of increase in global temperature includes in rise of sea level. Sea level increase is definitely the cause by which the greenhouse gases have been emitted, and through the uses of chlorofluorocarbon or certain type of chemicals by which the human activities have created a lot of changes into the planet's environment. Now let us discuss about the effects of global warming. First of all, we need to understand global warming is affecting our planet as a whole. being as a tourism student also, we need to understand that the activities in view of the indulgence of the tourism by the name of commercialization or making the tourist available at different places, the tourism activities by and large also affecting the environment, and therefore the consumption of or contribution of greenhouse gases have been emitted by the rapid tourism activities by the name of rapid transportation facilities, aviation, hotel industry, and so many other issues that we have already talked about in our last or previous session. As far as global warming's effects are concerned, they are very wide in nature, and to derive that is a special subject matter to be talked about. But if we are specifically talking in general about the global warming's effect, these are certain effects that we'll talk about. They're likely to have the extreme effects or occurrence of weather conditions, including heat waves, droughts, and heavy rainfall. Some or the other time, ocean acidification and specific extinctions due to shifting temperature regimes. You might have thought, what is the relativity between the global warming and the such change in the climate situations like commencement of heat waves, drought, floods, or heavy rains or acidification in the oceans? It is quite obvious that it is a natural environment which has been degraded, and degradation of natural environment is in the quest of changing the nature or tendency of their normal resources, and therefore the environment have caused a lot or affect a lot about our environment, our ecosystem, our weather, our climate in terms of the in earth, and then the human and other living beings. So it is what the drastic effect that we have seen. Affects significance to human includes the threat of food security, because human being, as though the commercial entity nowadays, they talk about earth or they exploit earth like anything, but definitely then also the food security is the core criteria by which we people are also being affected like anything. I believe food, mainly the vegetation, our agricultural work and other activities which is related to the final outcome for the food, for food requirement of living beings and mankind, have been drastically affected with the affection of the rain and monsoon season or certain other elements. Now let us talk about causes of global warming. As we have discussed in this particular process of discussion, the climate system can respond to changes of external forcing. External forcing can push the climate in the direction of warming or cooling. So climate system can respond to change in the external forcing. External forcing meant for, see, whenever we study the nature and tendency of environment, we understand the whole globe or whole earth is an entity. Let us presume the span as an entity of our earth. And if we are by and large talking about this particular earth as an element, then we can proceed that this particular area and this last area, they are interconnected. If this area is getting changed, definitely the entire planet, entire earth or entire system or subsystems into the earth will get a push, and this push have got a impact on climate in the direction of warming either or cooling. If at all you people are believing in the scientific facts, then we can take an example of Kirchhoff's rule related to heating or cooling. Once we are in terms of thermodynamics, we are making something, some area of an entity or a unit cool, then definitely the other end would be warm enough. The example of external forcing includes changes in atmospheric composition, that is, increased concentration of greenhouse gases. And this is one of the example by which the entire planet have been witness a drastic climate change. A climate or weather conditions those were prevailing in the recent past are not as continuous as it needs to be. There is an outcome of solar luminosity. Then the volcanic eruptions are also responsible for such global warming some or the other time and variations in Earth's orbit around the sun. So these are certain natural reasons. There are natural causes of methane. Methane is the Arctic tundra and wetlands. These are the areas which we have discussed. Wetland we have discussed through the last video session where we talked about these shabby areas are actually the grass root cause for the CH4 or called methane. Methane is one of the chemical or one of the gas which have got the inflammable aspect. Methane is greenhouse gas. A greenhouse gas is a gas that traps heat in the Earth's atmosphere, as I used to state in the earlier part of the session. The greenhouse effect keeps the Earth warm, like a blanket effect, and man-made causes. Pollution is the biggest man-made problem. Now, we may have a thought, what is pollution is all about? In our previous discussion throughout the classes, pollution is the main cause by which the human actions have created a substantial change in the elements, mainly the soil, mainly the water, mainly the air, mainly the other components of the planet Earth, which are very important, mainly the habitat, ecosystem, and so on. Therefore, it includes such things like burning or fossil fuel. So these are certain man-made causes. Now let us talk about the causes of sea level rise. What are the aspects? This part is also related to your syllabus. First, it's thermal expansion. Thermal expansion meant for as ocean water warms, it expands. It's a very simple science to understand. Whenever we are talking about the water or any entity, once it got the heat, the expansion will always be there, right? So thermal expansion, jaisa as we used to speak, jaise hum pani ko garam karte hain, uske andar prasar hota hai. That's called prasar or expand. The second is the form of contribution of land-based ice due to increased melting. And the major store of water or land is found in glaciers and ice sheets. I believe that our geography or our planet Earth is being set up like that where we have witnessed or we have studied that onto the poles and then different areas of the planet Earth, the ice glaciers are there. But due to the expansion in the thermal capacity of the water bodies, the apprehensions were getting into the glaciers. And now the glaciers are also getting a snooze. In terms of our syllabus, melting of snow cap is the example here, what I am mentioning here. Snow caps are the caps by the name of the ice or glaciers where the temperature conditions are in negative and therefore the water are under the freezed condition or in the ice form or glacier format. And due to the thermal expansion, the climate has been changed, so as the whole cycle of the planet, and because of the connectivity of planet one entity to the another entity, it has been affected drastically. The major store of water on land is found in glaciers and ice sheets, which have been drastically cross-rooted. I will quote certain example during this presentation, during this discussion or video session, where we will witness the loss of snow caps throughout the globe. Sea level rise is one of the several lines of evidence that supports the view that the climate has recently warmed. It is very likely that human inducted anthropological prospect in terms of global warming contributed to the sea level rise observed in the later half of 20th century. There are certain other causes which have been notified by International Intergovernmental Panel of Climate Change, the organization under United Nations Environmental Programs called IPCC in 2007 projected that during 21st century sea level will rise another 18 to 59 centimeters. It is all about 7.1 to 23 inches. This is a huge amount, but these numbers do not include uncertainties in climate carbon cycle feedbacks, nor do they include the full effect of change in ice sheet follows. Now, whenever we used to talk about, if we are taking or if we are referring the data given by IPCC, and if we believe that this is going to happen, think about the world, how would be the world is. Oceans or sea level will rise up to 60 centimeters. 60 centimeters is a huge margin. Throughout the globe, that meant for major islands will be vanished. Major vegetation will be under threat, or the climatic conditions will definitely change. Somewhere it will be rise of temperature, and somewhere in the melting of the snow caps, there'll be the temperature down, and because of temperature down, also the sudden climatic conditions will change, and it will change into the habitats and degradation of mankind and other living beings by their fatalities in terms of their living opportunities. On the time scale of centuries to millennia, the melting of ice sheet could result in even higher sea levels. So we are not very much sure what would be the exact proportion in terms of degradation or in terms of sea level rise. So sea level is definitely going to be affected by the rise of temperature condition throughout the planet, and this will definitely hamper the living beings, the plants, herbs, wildlife, habitats of different endangered and endangered species. And then you can think about, since it is the whole world which is connected to one to the another, then it may have the effect to one to the another. Long-term sea level changes, various factors affects the volume of mass of the ocean. Now we need to understand the word called volume and mass of the ocean. If the oceans are thicker, they will turn into the denser, and if they are denser, they may have the more masses, since there will be more water entity. It may lead to long-term changes in aquatic sea life. That includes, one is the temperature, second one is the masses of water locked on the land and sea, fresh water in rivers, lakes, glaciers, polar ice caps, and sea ice. Now mass and the volume change in the sea may cause the entire world a lot. It will be change of entire waves, air system, by which we are getting rains throughout by the name of monsoons and so on, and deserts will be changed into the more precise land, and vegetation may be lost. And since vegetation of typical lands may be lost, these sequence of the food chain may also be affected. Let us discuss global warming and its rising effect through the sea level. After last ice age, the rapid melting of glaciers rapidly raised sea level. The warming of the atmosphere caused by increase in greenhouse gases is melting glaciers and causing ocean water to warm and expand thermally. Again, we are talking the same thing. Since this is the expansion of the water, and therefore it will require more space than lands, or ocean tourism will always be a threat. So there is an interrelativity in terms of the effect of tourism on environment. Now, environmental effect on tourism, many islands will be lost, many vegetation will be lost, many sort of living beings in lost, and many other such interdependency phenomena may not be there. Since like we had talked about mangroves and wetlands, these are the areas by which the coastal area, coastal related erosion may be maintained. And since we had changed or drastically changed our structure of planet, then the fertilized soil will be lost, and therefore the desert will be converted into the more suitable place for fertility, or and the suitable places plants may be converted into the deforested land or something like that. So that will be a gradual change. There are three things to be talked about. Three things are major. I mean, once we are talking about rising sea levels throughout the planet, there are three things. One is thermal expansion. As we have talked about, when water heats up, it expands. About half of the past century, rise in water is attributable and warmer oceans simply occupying more space. In terms of occupying more space, the vegetation and aquity and life is being gradually changed. And many of species are under threat, and many of marine system, subsystem in aquatorian life has been changed drastically. Those are the eco-scientists, those are the marine scientists, they understand this phenomena. The density of the water have been changed gradually, and this affects the mankind like anything. Melting of glaciers and polar ice caps, large ice formations like glaciers and the polar ice caps naturally melt back a bit each summer. So this is another challenge, another term. So which is the second thing, melting of glacier and polar ice cap, which is a huge loss for the entire world. And you know what, these effects may not be studied so easily, because many places will be there in under drought, many places will always be there in flood, many places will not have the proper monsoon because of climate change. The air system or the air system routed through the seas will always change since the thermal expansion, and ice loss from the different or the major landscapes may have loss of vegetation, because the ice and glaciers into the planet are the real source of water for many or major population of the world. In terms of ice loss from Greece, Greenland and West Antarctica, this is one of the examples. These are three things by which we can understand that global warming, climate change or rising sea level is the most dangerous output because of certain natural and man-made activities. Effects of sea level rise, it may include increased coastal erosion as we have talked about, higher storm surge flooding, the huge floods with the lots and lots of storms in terms of coastal areas and the tropical and subtropical areas, inhabitation of primary production process. It will affect the processes of production, productivity in terms of life and productivity in terms of agriculture and certain other man-made activities. More extensive coastal induction will be there, and inundation may affect the life of the mankind along with the vegetation, flora, fauna, and definitely different species. Those are mainly the food cycle for that food pyramid. Then the chances of changes in surface water quality and groundwater characteristics. Now you may wonder that why these effects are under the impression of rising in sea level. Definitely rising in sea level will create a lot of changes in the marine life, aquatic life, and the connectivity of water bodies throughout the planet, and it may change the water quality, underground water and underground characteristics of the water. It may increase loss of property and coastal habitats, as we had already talked about, increased flood risk and potential loss of life. So in total, it is a loss for the entire planet. Impact of climate change on water and water quality and availability will always be witnessed in future. And I thought many parts of the world are witnessing it, like anything as of now also. Changes in water quality and temperature can also have sustainable impact on urban, industrial and agricultural use of venues, as well as on aquatic ecosystem. The urban water uses degraded water quality can also sustainability to purification cost. Students, whenever we talk about the impact of climate change on water and water quality and availability, will definitely be affected like anything. If we are not going to control this, we meant for the mankind or the whole planet, will see some drastic effect. Impact of climate change on water. Water is one of the key factor for life. Therefore, if anything or something is going to affect the water affect, because of water, it will affect anything or everything. Because I may not speak in a very important line as we used to speak in Hindi called Jal Hi Jeevan Hai. If water is going to be affected, the water quality will be affected, and if availability is going to be affected, the whole sum of life, whole sum of system of mankind, living beings, urban areas, industrial areas, agricultural areas, and total fabric of our ecosystem will be affected. Therefore, we need to understand and make a proper research on this particular note, so that the industry, the mankind, and the other dependency by the water, followed by the greenhouse effect or climate change or rising sea level, may be maintained. The impact of climate change on water and quality and availability may increase precipitation intensity. Precipitation, you can understand, suppose there is a water there in glass. If you are making the level change, definitely the precipitation intensity may be periodically changed. It may result in increased lot of chemicals or the components into it, which may lose their nature and can create a lot of impact on to the health of living beings. That includes plants, herbs, vegetation, wildlife, flora, fauna, mankind, and other living animal or plant beings. The water utility serving in many cities has identified heavy precipitation events as its major climate change related concern, because such events can rise turbidity level and surface water source as it affects monsoon and it creates moments also. In very layman's language, or in other words, we can understand the impact of climate change on water, water quality, and availability. First of all, the quality would not be as remain as same, or it will going to have some precipitation. And you know what? Precipitation, you don't know what kind of contamination will be there in the water. And therefore, the pure drinking water may not be available. And if at all we talk about the gratification in terms of the whole globe or the geographical interpretation of availability of water, we'll find there'll be certain areas where there will not available of the water, or we can see that there is accessibility in terms of flood or some other ingredients. So by the end of this particular session here, with the help of this particular discussion, we had covered unit number 3, of environmental concern, and which we had covered many topics like forecasting, creating environmental concern, rise in temperature, melting of snow caps, rise in sea level, monsoon and its changes. So these are the discussion that we have taken place. Students, again, it's not my motto to repeat this thing to you, rather to request you all, we all are there in a very difficult conditions. Therefore, you must take care of yourself, your parents, stay at your home, study hard, because study is the only thing that will change your life. And if you want to change anything in terms of a human being, you need to change yourself. Take care of yourself. I would like to place thanks to you all. Thank you very much. We'll see you somewhere else, sometime else, with these good words. Thank you. Namaskar.